Modern Chinese style arbors – image authenticity or distortion? Dzień dobry, szanowni państwo. Today, many design bureaus and construction companies suggest developing an individual project of a Chinese gazebo or offer typical designs of gazebos in the Chinese style with the use of modern materials. Landscape design companies also propose making a site plan for a Chinese or Japanese garden. The first feature of Chinese landscape design is the subordination of the social hierarchy while preserving the basic canonical techniques. The layout of the garden, regardless of its size, provided for a constant change of pictures where the central role was played by nature, which was delicately supplemented by architecture. So that the Chinese garden created in the 21st century does not become a distorted, erroneous copy, you need to know the main traditions on which the Chinese landscape design is based. It is a mistake to consider that setting up one gazebo with a concave roof or a Chinese red lantern with a hieroglyph on a personal plot will create an impression of China. We highlighted the 8 rules of canonical Chinese landscape design. The first and principal rule of the Chinese garden is that garden is an embodiment of an ideal harmonious world separated from the real world. It is the dominance of nature and emphasizing the secondariness of architecture in the natural environment. The garden in China was considered in the context of the 3 main ontological components of the world – heaven, earth, and mankind. The principal elements of the garden were water bodies and artificial or natural hills, while the area of water fields amounted to 3 or 5 of the entire garden. The elements created without human intervention were considered the most unexceptionable ones, such as natural stones, which inspired some associations, or rocks with their outlines, where natural forms and delicate human interferences were combined. The second role of the Chinese garden, and this is its difference from the European garden, is the lack of long-term prospects and the division of space into separate, independent landscape pictures that change like glasses in a kaleidoscope. The third role was the unity of landscape painting and landscape design when they obeyed a joint thematic genre. The fourth rule is to miniaturize the somewhere present real landscape with mountains, lakes, and rivers. The fifth rule refers to a specific list of the landscape design techniques. First, Shan Shui. Second, One Lake, Three Mountains. The technique is associated with the cult of Xian, legendary immortals of the Han Dynasty. It was believed that immortals live on the three divine mountains, and at the foot of the mountains there is a sea of immortality, which together, even in a small copy of the plot, ensures immortality to the garden owner. Third, Borowitz scenery. A different view was revealed behind each landscape picture, thus it's as if integrating a foreground landscape with a distant view outside the garden. Fourth, garden in garden. There is a smaller garden inside of the larger one. Fifth, framing. A landscape like a picture in a frame. Sixth, partition of the scenery. The sixth rule concerns the poetization of small architectural forms. pavilions, which receive a form and scale that is consonant with the natural environment and the name generated by either a view or an event or a poetic stanza. The eighth rule concerns programming a particular mood from a specific landscape picture: sadness, poetry, joy, inspiration, uplift, or peace, by selecting some components and placing pavilions that contribute to the maximum merger or a person in the pavilion with the surrounding scenery, and therefore often do not have walls, and the fancy roof seems to float on graceful high supports. Describing traditional techniques, designers often use atypical terminology and emphasizing the meaning of elements such as water and stone. They do not reveal the philosophical and religious content of the One Lakes Three Mountains technique. Designers generally do not mention this technique, which is canonical in most historical Chinese gardens, both imperial and private, but they talk about the balance between wood and stone and the perfect microcosm of the garden. And this explanation doesn't allow the customer to understand why the decoration of this garden, made of stones of the predominantly origin form and even with holes, would create an ideal world for him. Designers often call the principal elements of the Chinese garden the pagoda pavilion, which is reflected in the water mirror. But the pavilion and the pagoda are two different types of Chinese buildings. The Chinese never considered the artificially created building to be the main element of the garden. Such an element was an artificial lake with mountains around, a symbol of One Lake and Three Mountains, and the pavilions were considered a minor addition to the landscape. Moreover, they did not necessarily stand by the water. They could crown a hill or stand in January. Creating a modern version of the Chinese garden is a difficult task, since the designer must either reproduce the main feature of the traditional Chinese garden, eight of which were mentioned earlier, or follow the path of postmodernists and creatively rethink historical oriental traditions. Purposely hypertrophic iconic forms. However, a more typical European option is still an attempt to reproduce Chinese traditions and make the modern garden close to the original. A hallmark of Chinese architecture in general is that it cannot be precisely reproduced without knowing the basics of design and not understanding what exactly each element embodies. It is impossible to understand the nature of the Chinese garden if only to use the terms a garden for joy, a formidable garden, a moonlight window. Knowing that there should be a lot of stones and water, and all the pavilions should have a roof that is concave upwards. To create a convincing image of China in landscape architecture, you should not go from the mechanical list of the set of the principal constituent elements that mean something, but from the list of the techniques that are present in most gardens, since it was a particular technique that involved a combination of specific elements. Dziękuję bardzo za uwagę.